Patrick O'Brien's with me this morning. He's the UK Retail Research Director at GlobalData. Patrick, good morning.
Good morning.
Look, trading updates out from M&S and Debenhams this morning. A tough Christmas for both retailers. Just how bad's it been?
Well, it's been pretty bad. M&S is kind of a difficult one. They're down about 2 to 3% in both clothing and food. And that really is probably slightly better than expected. But you have to remember their expectations have been so bad over the last few weeks. Really what people were expecting are now kind of almost relieved that it's only minus 2% at M&S. But let's face it, this is long-term decline from you know, its biggest retailer at one point. Debenhams, we're really seeing a very, very bad results at the top line. But a lot of people, again, saying could have been a lot worse. They could have been talking about restructuring today, could have been talking about CVA. But really, they're saying the profits are on track. However, profits are only on track because now they've seen that there's more cost savings that they can make. So they're only because they're actually saving even more costs. And that causes a big problem for Debenhams, because their whole strategy is about rolling out this kind of the store of the future and all the learnings they've got from this big new store in Watford, but they haven't got the money to do it. They can't roll it out. So really, it's a real tight situation for Debenhams.
A tight situation, you say. So Debenhams, first off, what does the future hold for them? Does it have a future?
It's very difficult to, they do possibly have a future, but it's really going to be a lot about how it manages to negotiate with its landlords. It has extraordinary lease liabilities, extraordinary long leases, and the landlords, it's hard to get them to play ball, because if you're talking to a landlord individually, they don't want to be the one getting the haircut if no one else is. So it's really about getting that possibly a CVA in place later in the year, where at least then there's more transparency and landlords are more amenable to it. But of course, landlords won't do that unless things are so bad that that's the only option to take. And obviously, we might not be there just yet, but it's definitely a possibility this year.
And I suppose for M&S, clothing is one of the big issues for them, making it relevant once again, I suppose.
Indeed. I mean, that's really where M&S has been for so long now. Their clothing hasn't been resonating with their customers. The younger customers are going away to the online pure play such as Boohoo and ASOS. And it's just really been very, very difficult for it. Its stores are quite unimaginative. It's not really the shopping experience that they want. They have had some good points, of course. Looking at their online sales, they're up about 15%. So they have got their online proposition in a much better place than it's been.
So a glimmer of hope, you reckon, for both, given that they haven't revised down their profit forecasts?
Well, M&S have quite a big long-term strategy in place. They've got new people coming on board. Archie Norman's bringing his team all around him. And you can see that they've got possibility. Whether they can make that product relevant for their target audience is a really big if. Debenhams, though, it's much more about a cost shakedown. Can they actually struggle through and keep footfall coming into those department stores while cutting costs? Very, very difficult.
I suppose it's worth a quick mention on John Lewis enjoying a great Christmas period, on the other hand. What sets this apart?
Well, I'm not sure we'd say great. Pretty good, but only by comparison to the likes of Debenhams and M&S. And look at what they've also said about bonus. This could be the first time since the 1950s where they're not paying out bonus to their partners, their staff. And really what a lot of these updates are showing is that whilst sales might not be as bad as expected, we're not seeing, in a lot of these cases, how it's affected margins. And really, there's a big story to be told there. Have they discounted to get those margins in? John Lewis have got a strategy in place now where they're trying to move away from branded products where they're kind of they're screwed over by their own price guarantee. So they're trying to move to kind of more exclusive products and own brand products. Now, that's going to take a while. And in the meantime, margins are definitely going to be hit.
And more generally for the sector with this move from the high street to online, what's the outlook? What's your feeling?
Well, that's going to continue. There's no question that that sales will move from stores to online. And it's been going on now for decades. It's not stopping. And that means that we don't need so much physical stores, and that physical stores has to be cheaper rent. But of course, that's a difficult one for landlords to swallow. And if they've got you on long-term leases, they're not going to be letting you off very lightly.
Patrick, good to speak. Thanks for your thoughts this morning. Thanks for your time.
No problem. Thank you.